nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing.
Please be seated. Professor Joanne Sice, Senior Management and staff of the University, graduates, friends and family, good afternoon. My name is Pauline Carr and I am the Chancellor of the University of South Australia, and it is my very great pleasure to welcome you here today. At the outset, I acknowledge that this ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Graduands, may I be the first to officially congratulate you as graduands of the University of South Australia. We are so incredibly proud of you and very excited about the futures you start today. Most of you here today are embarking on a career that will see you develop the innovations of tomorrow. You do so with the skills you have learned at Australia's number one university for graduate employability. You will help build the world of the future, and you are ready. Your graduation is a milestone, the end of one journey and the beginning of another. One of UniSA's honorary doctors, tennis legend Yvonne Goolagong-Cawley, has a saying about that. Her foundation uses tennis to promote education, and its motto is dream, believe, learn, achieve. That is the journey that you have taken at university. You had a dream and you dared believe in it. You then showed the determination to come to UniSA to learn everything you needed to make that dream come true. And now you're ready for the final step, achieve. That dream you brought to us is now a reality. When you leave this hall as graduates today, you do so at an exciting time for South Australia. High-tech industries, dynamic arts, innovative agriculture, groundbreaking social enterprise, all that and much more is happening in the state right now. I know some people in this room will move interstate or overseas, and that's wonderful because you'll carry a little bit of UniSA out into the world with you. But for the many of you who will remain in South Australia, now is a time of opportunity. It's a time when our community is dreaming big, and we need you to help those dreams come true alongside your own. As you do so, remember that UniSA will always be with you. We have almost a quarter of a million people as part of our alumni family, based in over 130 countries, all achieving their dreams. And just as you step into an exciting future today, UniSA is doing the same. We are creating a new university in South Australia, and we're so very excited about that. You will all become alumni of the new institution and the benchmark and inspiration for its students. And we couldn't be more confident about the standards that you'll set for us. We are all walking into tomorrow together. But for today, please enjoy this moment with the people who love you the most. The people who have given you the love, support and encouragement that helped get you here today, your family and your friends. Graduands, to thank them, I ask that you stand up, face your loved ones and give them a big round of applause. Thank you, graduands. It is now my pleasure to ask our Provost and Chief Academic Officer, Professor Joanne Sice to address you.
Good afternoon, graduands. It is wonderful to see you all. I acknowledge that we are here today on Kaurna land, and I'm respectful of Kaurna people's ongoing connection with their land, waters and community. Graduands, today for you is a day of change. Your graduation is one of the most important events on your life's calendar. And while I know you'll be heading out of here to celebrate with the family and friends who helped to get you here, I want you to pause just for these next few minutes and reflect. Because by the time those celebrations start, you'll be different in such a significant and positive way. When you first arrived at the University of South Australia, you weren't quite ready for this day. You may have been ready to absorb the knowledge that was made available to you, but you weren't the you that will walk out of Pridham Hall this afternoon. You're about to graduate into the world, a world that you will perceive and understand in new and different ways because of what you've learned. During these past years, you've grown and developed your knowledge and skills with us at UniSA, and we are immensely proud of the people you've become. The university made available to you all our research and teaching, and we gave you opportunities to put what you learned into practice in real-world settings, but it was you that did the hard work. It wasn't easy, but it wasn't meant to be easy. It was meant to be transformational. In part, you have changed by absorbing all the knowledge and understanding you require for your new or your further career. The parchment you receive today is proud proof of your achievements. And your transformation is bigger than that. During your time at UniSA, you learned and questioned and relearned. You analysed and thought and reflected. You discussed and debated. And you became someone who values questions just as much as answers. UniSA also gave you the opportunity to encounter a wide range of new friendships, connections, and ways of thinking about and experiencing the world. And through that diversity, you've become someone who understands that so much more can be achieved when many points of view are considered rather than just one. The origin of the word graduate is grad, which means step incrementally by grade or by degree, in fact. You have stepped through your learning, gradually increasing your store of knowledge, practicing it, understanding how it fits into the world, and seeing how it contributes to your field and to society. And while each of those steps may have seemed inconsequential at the time, all of those incremental steps have brought you to this moment. As you cross the stage today, each step you take will transform you from graduand to graduate. Just think about how far those steps have taken you and how much further they will take you from here. UniSA has 240,000 alumni spread around the world. Our alumni have stories to inspire you, and importantly, they have advice to share with you. They are all people who, just like you, have taken steps to use their knowledge not only to succeed in a professional life, but to add value to community. The UniSA alumni who have stepped before you would advise you to be bold with your goals. They would encourage you to look for opportunities, to seek experiences rich in diversity and innovation. They would reassure you not to be frightened to step up and participate in new things. And they would remind you that to be happy in what you are doing is a key to success. For all our alumni, which will very soon include each and every one of you, university education was a transformational process. Your studies have instilled in you a passion to know more and to keep learning in every aspect of your life. That ability to continually learn provides the biggest opportunity of all, the chance to stay open to all the possibilities life will present. You will never stop learning, but in this next chapter of your journey, you'll have more opportunities to share what you know. Think of the people you look up to. Think of the people who have been generous and kind to you, and the people who have inspired and motivated you, and become one of them for others. And for today, this most important day, congratulations on your graduation. We are all very proud of you.
Thank you, Professor Sice. I now invite Professor Craig Williams, Dean of Programs, Science, Construction and Project Management, UniSA STEM, to begin the presentation of awards.
Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who fulfilled the conditions for admission to awards of this university. I request that awards be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Williams, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy by thesis entitled The Project Management Office, Critical Factors Influencing Selection and Deployment Decisions in Australia, Chancellor, I present Dr. Anthony John Wood. For the degree of Master of Applied Project Management, Daniel James Ioannidis. And Sajith Rajapaksa. For the degree of Master of Data Science, Jacinta Nyoki Kimani. And Min Tien Ta. For the degree of Master of Information Management, Library and Information Management, Courtney Elise Ladner. Michelle Mignon. Sandra Shea Nicholas. And Lauren Marie Pillar. For the degree of Master of Project Management, Boris Chan. Fatima Salma Rizvi. Jithmi Aranga Witharanaga. And Chi Ming Shao. For the degree of Master of Project and Program Management, Susanna Salandra. For the degree of Master of Research, Civil Engineering, Yang Qixiangping. For the degree of Master of Systems Engineering, Tracy Marianne Lee. For the Graduate Diploma in Building Surveying, Kumar Pushpa Gurung. Dakang Jiang. Joshua Matthew Kesby. Johanna McHale. Patria Jane Pritchard. And Feng Zhao. For the Graduate Diploma in Data Science, Stuart Michael Edwards. For the Graduate Diploma in Information Management, Archives and Records Management, Cindy Lee. For the Graduate Diploma in Information Management, Library and Information Management, Anne Katerina Beveridge. Illyria Erica Ichida Cody. Kylie Marie Quinn. Matthew Bruce Sykes. Bethany Erin Trigg. And Chantel Jane Wiles. For the Graduate Diploma in Project Management, Sasha Jade Arnold Boylan. Alana Rosemary Sidavarisi. Andrew David Johnson. Hongyi Zoe Xiao. And Gemma Walker. for the Graduate Diploma in Project Management, Contract Management. Minglu Sun. For the Graduate Certificate in Cybersecurity, Glenn Allen Rex Willits. For the Graduate Certificate in Data Science, Daniela Paz Barrientos Rivas. For the Graduate Certificate in Information Management, Morgan Victoria Claire Miller. For the Graduate Certificate in Project Management, Chukunoyalam Gloria Akuna. Patricia Lynn Conville Shaw. Travis Raymond George Norton. Trung Le Tien Phan. And Emma Steele. For the degree of Bachelor of Construction Management Honours, Ilham Ahmad. Demi L. Valderanos. Santo Francesco Caminiti. Luke Conti. Francesco Leo Frieda. Giorgio Calafatis. Jack Thomas James Kelsch. Cheng Nan Lo. Shuk Ting Lo. Matthew James Ma. William Newman. Dylan Palmese. Rahila Razai. Joseph Ruggiero. Andrew Douglas Stewart. Christian William Peter Theory. Brandon Huang Luat Tran. And Benjamin James White. For the degree of Bachelor of Software Engineering Honours, Libardo Abella Bajorquez. Jake Duragon. Benjamin John Harvey.
That's my boy.
Gemma Caitlin Loveys. Cameron Eric Margach. Lewis Paul Oborn. Kwok Min Pham. Jordan Kyle Robeson. And Christopher Ronald Taylor. For the degree of Bachelor of Construction Management, Muhammad Alizada. Nicholas Peter Angelos. Randy Martinez Bautista. Apostle Broikos. Ricky Lee Buxton. Alessandro Condello. Caleb Brody Crabb. Matthew De Alessio. Joseph Faila. Hare Krishna Anish Gajar. Lara Harris. Mitchell Brian Harvey. Nicholas Gregory Howe. Jonathan Hughes. Norhazila Ibrahim. Flynn Michael Johnston. Montazar Kashif Algita. Laura Legg. Jared Scott Marlowe. Andrew George Miller. T.S. Miller. Jeb Mitchell Nettle. Leo Panozzo. Adrian Mario Pacelli. Adam Joseph Pilkington. David Polidori. Joseph Raya. George Edwin Mendoza Rowan. Oscar Leshek Switala. Hong Lee Jason Tan. Thomas Tsantsidis. Jack Verbena. Aidan Murray Viney. And Kayu Zhang. For the degree of Bachelor of Data Analytics, Alyssa White. For the degree of Bachelor of Environmental Science, Alana Rose Marie Benson. Catherine Ann Bergen. Yanis Henny Bowe. Courtney Jane Brown. Adam Ronald Cochran. Rachel May Hall. Alexander Stewart McKenzie. Simpson Omabuck. And Charlotte Grace Way. For the degree of Bachelor of Information Technology, Cedric Romero Dongsal. Alexander Kuhlbach. And Wade McPherson. For the degree of Bachelor of Information Technology and Data Analytics, Jason Edward Hooper. and Peter William MacDonald. Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Williams. Graduates, you came to UniSA with your dreams, and we were delighted to help you learn everything you needed to bring those dreams to life. Now is your time. You are needed and you are ready. There will be challenges along the way, of that you can be sure, but you have the knowledge and the mettle to face those challenges. Another of UniSA's honorary doctors, Nelson Mandela, had a saying about challenges. He said, "I never lose. I either win or learn." Please try to carry that thought with you. You may be graduating from one of the world's top young universities today, but the learning doesn't end there. Keep learning throughout your life and you will never lose. Whatever you do next, I very much hope that you continue to stay in touch with us. Our alumni network is there for you and we always like to keep our UniSA family very close. The hall we sit in today, for instance, is named after one of our most inspiring alumni, businessman and philanthropist Andrew Pridham. And just across the laneway outside is our wonderful library, named after another alumni, artist Jeffrey Smart. Now, I'm not guaranteeing that you'll get your own building, but you never know, so please do stay in touch if you can. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank the battalion of university staff and volunteers who have done a wonderful job in preparing all the graduations over the last 2 weeks. So please join me in a round of applause for them. Graduates, as you leave, I wish you all the very, very best for your future. You have earned it and you deserve it. But before you go, please stay seated while the rest of us here today stand to congratulate you and wish you well on your journey.